Hello everyone, welcome to this new video of Prep Insta. In this new video, we'll be covering up everything that you need to know about TCS Ninja. So, you know, there's a lot of confusion about what TCS Ninja, Digital Innovator and everything else is. So, we'd like to debunk all of that in this video, and anything and everything that you need to know about TCS Ninja, maybe how to apply for TCS Ninja, the kind of questions that will be asked, the interview grading scheme, and you know, many good things will be covered in this video. We'll also like to tell you that, you know, 91% of the students which were placed in TCS had prepared from Prep Insta this year. So, you know, you should really trust whatever that we are giving you, and we'll tell you on the way as we go through the video the things that you need to take care of. Right. So most of you would know who am I. My name is Atulya Kaushik. I'd like to tell, you know, more information so that, you know, it makes a more trustworthy scenario for all of us to listen to me. I'm the founder of the website Prep Insta, and you know, we've helped about 15 lakh students to get placed, and I was the winner of the Chancellor's Excellence Award at VIT Vellore, and was placed in 8 companies on campus and 5 different companies off campus. And a lot of packages of mine were more than 10 lakhs, and I've also cleared TCS in my college times. So let's just go with the video. In this video, we'll be covering up, you know, introduction about, you know, TCS Ninja, the new pattern that TCS Ninja has, you know, written test pattern and the interview grading scheme. And in the end, there's a big surprise that is coming for you. So, you know, you should wait for it. So, how to apply for TCS Ninja. So first, you should understand the difference between normal TCS and TCS Ninja and TCS Digital and so on and so forth. So as we had covered in the earlier video, TCS Digital was a recruitment test which was giving a higher package and a much better profile than, you know, TCS or TCS Ninja. They only have a few positions all over the India. I think about 200 to 300 positions are offered. However, for TCS, they are looking to recruit about 5 to 10,000 people this year, which is half than last year. So it is going to be very competitive this year, because number of people applying should have also increased, but the seats have gone down by 50% because the IT trend is not so good. So generally, normal TCS will visit the top, the following colleges, which are cream colleges, premium colleges and grade A colleges. So basically these are the top 300, 400 colleges. Obviously there are 5,000, 6,000 colleges in India. TCS cannot individually visit all of them, right? So they just visit top 300, 400 colleges to get the best of the students. But, you know, we are very sure that even they are very sure that there are a lot of good students in other colleges that they cannot visit. So, which is why they've come up with TCS Ninja. It is an, you know, national recruitment test for TCS, and all the colleges in India which are accredited by AICTE, and they can be grade BCD and call BCD colleges, are eligible for TCS Ninja. So if TCS has already visited your campus or is planning to visit your campus, in that case TCS Ninja notification you will not get by your placement cell. So let's just see how to apply for it. So first of all, you should know that the drive will only start in you know, late August or early September. So, you know, if you ask your placement officer, they will only say, give you the same information that you need to wait, and we need to get a notification from TCS's end. So, you know, you should first ask your placement officer on how to apply. They will generally, whenever the drive is supposed to happen, they will generally send out an email to all the students on the whole procedure. So the procedure will be the same. You have to go to nextstep.tcs.com and register and fill out the whole application form. And we have an off-campus drive page on TCS. You can just Google TCS off-campus drive page or TCS off-campus drive 2018, and that page will come on the top for Prep Insta. The first position will be ours, so you can click on that, and you know, there we've given next the process of filling the application form, which is the same for on campus and off campus as well. It's just that you know, when you're filling the form, a few fields change. So for TCS Ninja, a few fields will change, right? And that complete process, you know, it's very easy to identify what to do, what not to do. So once you fill the application form, you know, you haven't actually applied to TCS Ninja, because they will eventually be sending you an activation code, and they will send it to you via your placement cell. So you need to go and ask for an activation code from your placement office, and they will give you this activation code, and then you need to go again to the next step, .tcs.com, and apply this code. So I think the activation code, you need to wait until and unless your placement officer tells you. So even if you go and apply to nextstep.tcs.com, in that case, you will not be a complete registration, right? And if you are a student of 2018 batch, which have already passed out in 2017, I think they can also apply. You can just email your TC, your placement officers and placement cell, and you know, you can just simply tell them that I want to apply for this drive. Please give me the detailed procedure and the activation code. And as we tell, the test will only start in late August and July. Right, so the difference between TCS and TCS Ninja, in a more detailed manner, TCS will visit every college individually, will conduct the interview round and the online test round on campus itself. However, TCS is the national qualifier test. Colleges that TCS does not visit, those are applicable for TCS Ninja, and there will be online tests which will be on your campus. And you know, for interviews, we've contacted a lot of HRs and a lot of people working at TCS, because you know, we generally have a lot of off-campus drive which are in exclusive partnership with us. So we have very good relations with the HRs of different companies. So what TCS HRs have told us that there are two processes wherein if number of colleges in a particular city are more, so what they'll do, they'll have a pool campus wherein the biggest campus of that city will be serving as an interview location, and TCS employees and TCS HRs will visit that particular campus and conduct interviews. If it's a small city, then you know, the TCS will ask you to visit the nearest TCS office on a particular given date, which will be pre-notified to you. So nothing to be worried about that. So everything will be communicated, and you know, your placement cell again should be the best information source for anything. So just bug your placement cells, and I think the recruitment numbers are going to down by are going to get down by 50%. So in that case, the preparation should not stop, right? Because there are about 3 to 4 lakh people applying, and the number of seats are 10,000 for TCS Ninja, and you can understand, right, how hard it's going to be. Only top 5-6% students are going to get selected, right? So in that case, your preparations should start now itself, as early as possible. You should not wait for 2-3 days, because people are already preparing. So you need to have an edge over them. So we'll tell you, you know, Prepinsta is obviously the best source. We are the most trusted website, and you know, by far, we are the most visited websites for placements, as all of you know, right? So a few things more, TCS Digital Chance is also there, you know, for people who attended TCS Digital Drive and did not clear it, for people who did not attend TCS Digital Drive. In that case, if you perform really well in TCS Ninja test, then the top 10% performing students will be given a chance to have a direct interview for TCS Digital. But don't worry, you know, even if you do not clear the TCS Digital interview, you'll again be given chance for TCS Ninja interview. So it's just that, you know, in case they've missed a lot of students who were capable for a higher package of 7 lakhs and 7.2, I guess, in the case of M.Tech students. So this is not your last chance. You need to get your foot on the pedal and just prepare well. So, you know, you from a package of, I think, 3.5 lakhs, you can go up to 7 lakhs. So if you prepare really, really well, you know, your I think if a student starts from 3.5 lakhs, so to go till 7 lakhs, it will take in his corporate light, it will take him about 3 to 4 years, right? So I think if you prepare hard for 15-20 days, you will save 3 to 4 years of your life, right? And we all want to make our parents proud and get a better life with a better money. That is a basic necessity of life, right? So just what I'll suggest, again I'll focus, start your preparation now, best preparation. Give daily at least 7 to 8 hours for preparation, and it will be enough. A lot of our, we'll cover about the materials later, I think. This is not the right time to be able to do so. So let me tell you about the TCS Ninja pattern, as we earlier had, right? We give you the best pattern ever. So even in the case of TCS Digital, we gave you the grading, you know, for grade A colleges and grade B and premium colleges, what is the difference between the pattern, and that was completely true. And you know, a lot of students thanked us, and a lot of students who were from grade B and C colleges also had this pattern that is there in TCS Ninja as their first round of test. And 50% of them who didn't prepare from Prep Insta did not even know, they just thought that, you know, general English proficiency and advanced coding and all rounds will be there, but these tests were also there for them. So let me cover about TCS Ninja in detail. There are four sections: aptitude and logical. Generally it's aptitude, right? 20 questions are there. 18 questions are general questions, which are of 1 mark each. 2 questions are star marked questions. There is nothing called blue star marked questions. There is only star marked questions, right? And I think they'll be colored in black. So black star marked questions in that case. And negative marking is there in this particular test. So for a non star marked question, that is for 18 questions, 0.33 negative marking will be there. And for 2 star marked question, 0.66 negative marking will be there. And if you answer the star mark question, instead of 1 mark, you will be given 2 marks. So the time given for this section is 40 minutes. Then there is email writing test. In email writing, 1 question is there and 10 minutes is there. So, you know, we are also conducting a online live class and a lot of paid materials. If you don't want to attend the online live class, a lot of paid materials are there in which we'll be covering detailed information about all these, you know, that no one knows. So for example, in TCS email writing, a TCS recruiter will not check your email. An AI algorithm that is developed by TCS checks your email and gives you marks. So right, we have all that information about, you know, on what parameters does AI award you marks, like missing a colon, missing a comma, and not having an exclamation mark, and you know, missing the punctuation. And you know, there are approximately 30 to 40 different parameters, and we'll be covering that in our live video session. I'll tell you about that later, and you know, it's already there in our paid material in case you don't want to attend the live classes and just start from the previous year's paper. So we'll cover that later. And then there is CMCQ test, which has 10 questions and the time given is 20 minutes. In there again, there's a negative marking. In email writing, there's no negative marking, only in aptitude and CMCQ test, there is a negative marking. Then there is command line programming. Now, command line programming is completely different from C++, a normal code that we write. And if you don't know how command line programming is done, you wouldn't be able to clear the TCS test. And I'm sure the people who've already studied from our website or who've already tried to study for command line programming, they know that over the whole internet, you try to find anything about command line programming, you will only find it on Prep Insta. And you know, we feel a lot of pride in saying this, that yes, we have the latest information that no one else has, right? And a lot of websites are copying us, trying to copy us, but you know, they fail to do so, providing the best content that we do and the best information that we do. So then there is a technical interview round, which will last about 30 to 40 minutes. Yes, in case of other companies like Cognizant and Wipro, this only lasts for 10 to 20 minutes or 15 to 25 minutes, but TCS tries to test you, and you know, they'll grill you, they'll ask you different topics. So we'll cover that in this video later. And then there is a you know, other videos about each of the sections. So we have a video about command line programming, we have a video about email writing in detail on our YouTube channel, so you should check out that also. Then there is an HR interview, which is of 10 minutes, right? And it's a basic HR interview, and you know, the technical interview, HR interview, and then there is managerial interview. So we'll tell you about that. About the aptitude round, so we've done a lot of data analytics on number of questions that are asked from each section. So always from probability, there's one question. Always from permutation, combination, number series, LCM, there's one question. In case of clocks and calendar, either there is one or there are two. So you know, you can see like allegations and mixtures here, either there is zero question or one question. So you know, we've only done that to help you all. And a lot of data analytics is also applied here. So all the data and facts that you get are only available on PrepInsta. So we, you know, probability of the question being a star marked question is also given here. So a geometry question and a reasoning question has a very high probability, and like a series and progression question has a very high probability to be a star marked question, right? And in that case, you also see, right, the number of questions generally are 2 or 2 to 3, and again in series and progression 2. So you know, one will be non-star marked, one will be star marked, and you know, it's not that a star marked question cannot be asked from a topic, say probability. It has a low probability of being a star marked question, but yes, there could be rare chances in which you know, star marked questions from probability can come, right? So let's go through the email writing points. We are just doing a crisp introduction. I think we'll cover email writing with a 2 to 4 hours video in our live online live classes, but you know, with the time that we have now for a general observation, I think this is enough. So number of minimum words is 50, number of maximum words is 100. No one tells you this, you know, we are only telling you this, and we've only done that by having in some insider information. And spellings is a criteria. If you don't know any spelling, just don't write it. Maybe use a alternative synonym of that word rather than writing a wrong spelling, right? And punctuations are very important. So, you know, a lot of students miss. Like I said, a lot of students miss, right? So after students, I should ideally put a comma when I'm writing, right? So that is missed by a lot of students. So punctuations is very important. Grammar is important. Like we get about 400 messages every day on Facebook wherein students want to buy our paid material or anything. So what they say is, I buy your paid materials. And you know, I think 50% of you, because would not notice that I buy your paid material is wrong. I buy your paid materials completely wrong. I think if you did not figure out that I said anything wrong in the first go, you are probably very weak in English, because this is very basic English thing. I bought your paid materials. Bought. It's not buyed. Y-E-D is not there. Buy, bought is there. The second form and third form is bought, right? It's not buyed. So, you know, a lot of students have a misconception about the second and third form, and I did not buy your paid material, or I did not bought your paid material is also wrong in that case, because in a sentence there can only be one third form. If you are using did, then there is no need to write one more third form like bought. So it should be, I did not buy your paid materials, not I did not bought your paid materials. That is completely wrong. So same way, I did not saw is wrong, I did not see is right. Right, so we'll just go through it. Paragraphization is very important. So let me tell you why email writing round is there in TCS, right? In any given IT company, about 40 to 50% of your work in any given day would be to speak to your clients over calls and Skype and emails, right? And most of there, you will be a carrier of TCS pride, right? And the coding and everything that goes on happens on back end, and client does not know at a point that, you know, what code you're writing, but he gives but the emails that you're writing give him an impression on, you know, how good you are working. So if you write a very bad English email, if you write very bad email, it gives a very bad impression on TCS, even if you're a very good coder. But if you write a very grammatical errorness email to any particular client, and you know, he will lose faith in you, and he will eventually have a psychological aspect in losing faith in TCS as well. So just to make sure that you are capable of writing a good email when you join the company, this round is there. And with any given email, paragraphization is very important. So imagine if I did not put it in the bullet points and I did not give any paragraph, it would be very hard for you to read. Or imagine like a reading comprehension, wherein reading comprehension is very big and no paragraphs are there, right? It is very hard to you know, find out any information. But if paragraphs, reading comprehension of let's say 1,000 words is divided into 10 paragraphs, in that case, you know, you will easily find a lot of information. So you know, any particular email, the TCS AI also gives you mark if you paragraph your email. So at least 2 paragraphs should be there. And you know, using heavy words are considered to be proficient in English, but TCS will not award you any marks for that. So we advise you to write a normal English. Don't use words like extravaganza or things that you cannot pronounce. You know, I met a few students who were mugging up words from dictionary that, you know, we want to use these words in TCS email writing, and you know, that is not going to award you any marks. Your email should be crisp, clear and understandable, right? You're not a poet, you're not a English grammar student, you would be an IT professional. You have to make clear what idea or what problem you are trying to solve to your client. So all these points, just make sure. We also have a lot of points which we'll cover in the, I guess there is an email writing video also on our web, on our YouTube channel. You can check out that, and if you join the live classes, in that case we'll cover this in detail. Right, so then there is CMCQ section. So we've noticed that, you know, a lot of confusion is there in the market, and a lot of random topics are given and everything. No data analytics is applied, nothing is applied. So the only topics for CMCQ sections are these, right? And you know, a few object oriented programming topics also, but only a limited amount of object oriented programming. But the most important are these, which are C, loops, arrays, command line programming. Yes, apart from the command line programming coding questions, there are theory questions of command line programming also, and you will get this only information on Prep Insta. I'm sure all of those who've seen this video, after you give your exam, you will thank us that, you know, I got to know from Prep Insta that command line theory questions in CMCQ section will also be there apart from the coding section. So then there is libraries, variables and registers, and file handling, right? And so command line programming, I don't think that I can cover command line programming in detail on this video, because this command line programming is actually very vast, and it needs to take about 2 to 3 hours at least to cover the basics about command line programming. So either you can go to our command line programming dashboard and study theory from there, and there are 3-4 videos about command line programming as well, and watch those videos and you can get a fair idea, right? So we'll just cover a few things that you need to know about command line programming, TCS platform. So there is only one question that is for 20 minutes. You can only compile 10 times. You will not get this information anywhere else. If you compile more than 10 times, I think a lot of, because we do not even know this, but a lot of students have told us that after compiling 10 times, a pop-up comes in the exam that says you've reached your quota of maximum compilations, right? And the coding platform is divided into two. So 50% of your screen is divided into writing code, and other 50% is divided into writing the output, right? So you should write the whole program in the right hand side. And as command line programming basics, you can't use inputs like scanf, getch, getchar to get inputs from the user. And input should only be read as command line programming arguments, right? And a lot of students have done this, that, you know, for example, you have to print 5 as an answer for any output. So what they've done, they use printf at the very end and printed 5. That is not going to work for TCS, because they have a lot of test cases. About 100 test cases are tested, and I think 3 of the test cases are given for you to test, and apart from that, 97 of the test cases, they don't tell you that they are checking, but they are checking them, right? So any particular question that you get, you know, printing using printf and getting the answer is not going to help you, right? And they mentioned the 4 test cases, I'm sorry, not 3 but 4, that is pass fail. They indicated by like private and public classes, and they've not mentioned in the test case. And you know, one more thing I'll mention, that earlier we told you that 10 time is the maximum time of compilation, but also, you know, the compilation at the TCS platform also takes time. And the reason, we've already written the email to TCS about highlighting this fact that, you know, a lot of students are facing this problem, that your compiler takes 25 seconds, and in that 25 seconds the screen gets blocked. And a few students also think that, you know, their system has become hanged up and it's not responding, but it's not like that. For 25 seconds the screen gets stuck, and your code is compiling. So what we tell you, one thing, we've already written email to them to fix this, that the compiler time is very high for you. So what they've responded back is that they can't do anything about it, because about thousands and thousands of people are giving tests simultaneously, so you know, a very high load is on their server. So they are trying to reduce it by putting more servers, but still the compiler time is going to be high enough, right? So in that case, first of all, 25 seconds of your coding time is getting wasted, and if you do that 10 times, right, a lot of time, 300 seconds of your time is getting wasted. That is approximately close to 5 minutes, right? So you should not compile again and again. You should cross check, verify, and once you are very sure that this should work, then compile again, and then maybe there can be a few errors at the boundary positions and anywhere, then you can compile again. Right, and I would just want to give a basic overview about command line programming. So in command line programming, int function, int main function looks like this, wherein int argc and argvs are there. So what is argc? Argc is the argument count. So for example, you are passing an array, right? So in that case, the number of elements in the array are, let's say, 5. In that case, argc will represent as 6. Argc value will be 6, because always, like, there's a default argument in command line programming. So whatever arguments that you put, right, at A0 position, a default argument will be there, right? So let's just go ahead with the next one. Then there is argv. The pointer contains location of all the values and arguments. Then there is star argv, array of values of all the arguments. So if you want to take an input in a for loop, then argv will be the best parameters to be taken care of, right? So I think this will create a lot of confusion for you guys. So if you didn't understand this, no problem, just watch our command line programming videos, go to our command line programming dashboard, and that will help a lot. This is the only resource over the internet for command line programming. Trust me guys, this is going to help you a lot. If you ignore command line programming or coding question, you will not get into TCS. Even if you score very less in aptitude and logical and email writing and any email writing round, no problem. But if you don't get the output in command line programming, you're not going ahead to the next round, because essentially TCS is recruiting coders, right? So if you can't write code, it is going to be a bad thing for you, right? So just give me one, the 10 seconds, we'll take a break. I'll have water and then we'll continue this video. Yes, so we can just go ahead. I don't think why it says subsequent subrelation problem. So examples of command line programming questions that you will get in the exam would be, convert decimal to octal number, palindrome number, and Armstrong number. So in our website, we've given a few basic programs to start with so that you can understand the command line programming concept, and then go ahead with the hard problem. So it's not worthy to, directly move you to the decimal and octal, which is a very hard program to understand in a first go. So these are the sample programs. Then comes the interview bit part. The interview conducted will be in three parts, that is technical round, managerial round, and the HR round. So we'll cover that. First, I want to highlight the differences between CSIT and a non-CSIT people. Right. So in CSIT, they try to in CSIT or non-CSIT, they obviously try to stick to the technologies mentioned in your resume. So first of all, they'll ask for your resume, and in from that, obviously, if you mention C, C++, Java, and whatever programming, right? And I think you've only mentioned that since you know, and no need to mention any high technologies like Perl, Ruby, Python, if you don't know it, and maybe probably if you only studied it for 5-6 days and not more than that. If you don't know how to write a code in particular language, very deeply, don't write it in your resume, because if they ask questions from that, and they will definitely ask questions from that, it will be a bad point for you if you're not able to answer any particular question. So only stick to your strengths and only mention what you know. Right. So, in both of those CSIT and non-CSIT questions from C, C++, that is object-oriented programming, will be asked. For CSIT people, they will obviously be asking a deeper computer science concepts like software engineering and data structures. And, you know, I don't think they will ask data structures to all of them. But yes, if they see that, you know, you are very bright student and you have a lot of good things in your resume, they can ask you data structures questions. But generally, they try to stick to basic things like in software engineering, they'll ask you name different type of data, you know, software engineering models like waterfall, spiral, and agile, etc., etc., right? And if any of the following questions like DBMS and operating systems and computer networks is mentioned in the resume, then they'll go ahead with that one. In DBMS, they can ask you like what are asset properties and what is nested queries. Write a SQL code or query for, you know, fetching the top three results from a particular table and all that. So these are very basic questions. I don't think there should be any problem with that. The most important thing that they are looking for, that if you speak good English or not. Again, you have to speak to the clients over Skype call. So good English is very necessary. Then, you know, for non-CSIT people, obviously you don't know DBMS, computer networks and all. And so what they'll do is that they'll ask you from your own branch. So, you know, your interviewer may be from a EEE or non-EEE, or if let's say you are from a EEE branch, your interview may be from a mechanical branch or from automotive branch or biotech or maybe from EEE. So in case he's from EEE branch, he will ask you questions from EEE on his own, right? And in case he's from non-EEE branch, so what he'll do, he'll probably ask you basic definitions from class 11, 10, 12 that we've seen of EEE, like what is Kirchhoff's law and different kind of EEE 101 questions, like what are different ways of solving you know, any algorithms. Then he'll Google interview questions asked in for an electrical student. So I think what you can do, you can also Google the same before your exam, because he will definitely be Googling that if he's a non-EEE student. And you know, very basic definitions, no need to worry about that. If you've studied them, you'll be able to answer, right? It's just that you have to frame that in a proper English, right? One definite question that is going to be there for both of them, that is CSIT and non-CSIT, that is questions on final year project. And they'll ask you to make the circuit diagrams, which in case of a CSIT student, there are no circuit diagrams, they'll stick to theory and, you know, coding questions. But in case of EEE, EC and EIE branches, the circuit diagrams are very big and very complicated, and maybe you wouldn't even remember them, right? Or maybe if you're making the, maybe if you've not even started with the final year project, right? So just make sure that you are able to answer questions. If you have not started with the final year project or mini projects, just tell them that we don't have any. And if you have a mini project already, make sure that you know all the formulas, all the definitions, all the diagrams related to it, because this is going to be very vital. If you don't know, you know, from TCS's perspective, you've done a mini project or a final year project and wasted about 1 to 2 years, 1 to 2 months of your time. And if you don't know basic definitions and diagrams, they think that you're not very academically sound. So very bad impression goes that way. So the only difference is for CSIT and non-CSIT, C, C++ is common. For CSIT, a little basic definition of their own subjects, and for non-CSIT, a little basic definitions of their own subjects, right? And generally, they will be Googling that, right? And project-based questions are a must, right? And generally, what they do is they ask you like, what is your favorite subject? And then they'll ask you questions from that, or they will ask you rate yourself out of 10 in Java, or rate yourself out of 10 in C, C++, so on so forth. And then based upon that, anyways, even if you rate yourself 5, they are going to ask questions. But if you're not able to answer, at least they'll have an impression that, you know, at least you were honest, right? So let's just come to the technical interview round. The technical interview round, command on procedure. So you know, this is the grading scheme. So when any interviewer who's taking your interview round will give you grades out of A, B, C, D, E, F, right? And they have to fill a Excel sheet and submit it to their managers, right? And then they will upload it to the system, and the system will finally take the written round marks and the interview round marks and declare the whole marks, and then they will enter how many students, top students they want to select, and automatically it will give the list of top, let's say if they want to select top 100 students, then the written round marks, then the interview round marks total, and the top 100 students in that list will get selected. So you know, A, B, C, D, E, F grades they will be giving for to you on each of those these topics. Command on procedural language, that is if you can write code in the non-object oriented programming language like C, C++, or basically if you know basic definitions. Command on object oriented language, that C, C++, they will ask you questions like, you know, what difference between Java and C++, or difference between C and C++, or they will ask you to write a code explaining polymorphism, or just simply the definition of polymorphism. So those questions will encounter for marks in this particular talk, grade. Then general branch specific question, and then verbal communication. If you have a very good comprehensive English and command on English and you're able to communicate really well, in that case they will give you marks for this. So technical round, only four parameters on which you will be given marks, right? Then there is managerial round. So this is only there in TCS. I don't think any other company takes. So this is only done the concept of managerial round comes because you're good in technical. But from a manager's perspective, you should also have a like a teamwork type of personality. You should be very confident to go out and help others and take helps from others. And at times your deadlines will be missed. You are working on a project. In that case, you will have to work on Saturdays and Sundays out of your own time, because you need to take responsibility for your own work, right? They will not tell you that you can't tell the people that I cannot work on Saturdays and Sundays. I'm sorry that I was not able to finish this in time that I had asked for. So let's just tell client that we'll not be able to deliver. Anyways, if you made a commitment to a client, that has to be completed anyhow. So that is your own responsibility. So time management skills, confidence, outgoing friend, friendly personality, team player, and collaborative skills. So they'll generally ask you questions like situational based questions, that for example you have to go home on a holiday and from client a new project has come which has to be completed in time, and the team is not able to, and in that case you are asked politely to can you reschedule your holidays later. What will you do in that case? So they obviously, I think everyone will answer that it's a critical situation for the project, and in that case I will schedule my holidays at Diwali or Holi and whenever to a later point in time. So those kind of questions, confidence questions, on team player based situation questions. So just make sure that because they'll be giving you marks on these four categories, so make sure whatever answer that you give display these four characteristics in you. All right, then there's a human resource round in which they'll ask you questions related to relocational willingness, like if you are from Chennai and if you are located in Chandigarh, will you be willing to change your location? And knowledge about TCS, they'll ask you questions about who's the founder of TCS, when was TCS founded, in which cities does TCS have offices and all. They'll also check your dress code, if you're dressed smartly or not, and if you have stains on your shirt and all. A few students have also been asked questions like, what do you want to do after 5 years? And a lot of students said that we want to pursue MBA. I think that gives a very negative effect on HR. Never say that you want to leave TCS. Just always be like, what I used to do. I used to create fake stories about that my relatives work in your company, and I'm very passionate about joining your company because my parents talk all about that cousin of mine, and I feel really inspired to join your company. So in that case, it gives a very good connect that yes, this person will stay in TCS for a very long time, even if you wouldn't, but at least in the interview, right? So, you know, they'll calculate all the top scores, and then yes, I said project based questions. I think we've already covered that in detail. No need to have that. So HR questions are like these, you know, are you preparing for MBA, team player, are you willing to relocate, are you willing to work on weekends and in night shift, how do you, so this is very famous questions, how do you expect a mechanical engineering student to learn and work in a software company? So what I will suggest you is be honest, right? There's nothing, you know that a mechanical student, it's very hard for a mechanical student to get a job in a core sector, and even the interviewer knows. So why not tell him the truth, right? That many companies don't come to my college for mechanical, and I have a financial issues that I have to get working and support my parents, support myself, and you know, I've given 4 years of my life to study something. I'm sure that the projects that I will get in TCS somewhere and some point in my life, I will be able to apply those skills somewhere subconsciously. And regarding, you know, coding and all, I'm a very passionate coder, and you know, if given a chance, I will learn as much as I could about coding, and I already know this much about coding, and you know, I'm willing to learn. Just say the truth, and you know, you admire a company like TCS, and a lot of your seniors also, which are non-CSIT people, are working in TCS, and they've given a very positive response to you about a non-CSIT person working in an IT company. So you're very confident that you will be able to succeed and do well in the company. All that is required is hard work, and you're willing to give that hard work. So just be very confident in answering that particular question, right? And what are your future goals? How do you see yourself after 5 years? So these kind of questions, right? So a few facts. 91% of the people who were placed in TCS were from Prep Insta. Apart from TCS, 95% were placed in Infosys. We have about 11,000 AMCAT 99 percentilers. So what happens, a lot of students get unplaced after placements, or even if they are placed, they want a better package. So they can go to myamcat.com, and you know, a lot of companies recruit on the scores of your AMCAT. So you give AMCAT and you get your scorecards. And on the basis of scorecards, companies like TCS, Wipro, Infosys, Microsoft, and Emphasis, and you know, about 400 different companies recruit off campus based upon your AMCAT scores. And we have 11,099 percentilers and more, right? So Prep Insta is the best place for you to study, and 91% for TCS, and about 53% has joined of the students had joined our preparation code. In there are two ways to join our TCS Ninja preparation course, we'll tell you. So we'll come to that big surprise now. I'm sure all of you would have had been waiting for it. So let's just go to our website, prepinsta.com. So what you can do, you can go to TCS Ninja main dashboard here. Yeah, let's go to there in a new tab, right? So you will come here, you will come on this page. So here you have all the dashboards of TCS, quants, email writing, and command line, and individual places, because we can't fix all the information on one page, right? So we need to have different pages for the same. So all the detailed facts and analysis we've done here. So there are two courses. One is the online live classes, right? And they are starting on 6th of August, and after 6th of August, I think they will start every week. Every Monday, we'll start one more live class for students. So after 6th, I think 13th, we'll start again. Then I think 19th, we'll start again. Then 25th, we'll start again. So we'll update you. You can just visit this particular page, and you can click on register now button, and you can attend the online live classes. So the current live online live classes, or any given online classes, will be of 14 days. So if you start on 6th of August, then it will end on 19th of August. If you start on 13th, so this page will get updated for the next online classes, then 13th of August will be the next batch, right? So in that case, starting from 13th of August, then 14 days we'll have online class for. So you know, this is this class, every day 2 hour classes will be there, online class, and you can watch this video. So if in case you miss any particular video, and you're busy at a particular point in time, I'm sorry. Yes, you can visit the link that we give you to watch the online live class, and you can watch the videos again and again if you want to, as many number of times, and you will additionally get all the previous year papers of TCS. After each and every class, we will give you questions to practice. Those are previous year TCS questions, and we have students telling us that about 60-80% of our questions are repeated in the exam, right? And mock tests are there on our website, and there's 100% money back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, we'll refund you the money. And the access to the WhatsApp group is there. For students, let's say, because this is very frequent that students who give the TCS Ninja test before you will share their questions in the exam on this group and whatnot. So in that case, that this is really helpful. And even if you are facing any problem with a particular question, you can just post that in our WhatsApp group, and other students will also help you, and even our tutors will help you. So live classes will cover everything, that is aptitude, email writing, then command line, and then TCS CMCQ section, and about 2 hours every day. The big surprise here is that right now the cost of the course is 2,999 rupees, and you will get a straight discount of 1,000 rupees if you register now. And the above is only valid for first 50 participants. Once we get these 50 participants, this code, TCS Ninja code, will be no longer valid in that case. So just hurry up. And a lot of students have also told us that they don't want to waste time for online live classes because they've already done their preparation. I will suggest them to go ahead with the online live class, because there we will be able to help you in a much better way. But in case you just want the previous year papers and practice them, then we have that also. So either you can go with our basic materials or you can go with our paid materials. So these are all the previous year questions of TCS Ninja, and the pro material have 2x more questions and 4x more chance of repetition, and each section we have that. So if you only want to buy for quants, you can only buy for quants, right? And if you only want to buy for, let's say, CMCQ section, you can only choose to buy that. But in case you join our online live classes, you will get all the paid materials in this. You can watch this again and again. And if you have any doubt, what we'll suggest you is that this is the number. You can always make a call on this number, clear all your doubts, all the questions that you have before joining this online live class, or maybe you can only WhatsApp on this number, right? And we are also giving a referral free of 500. If you refer a friend of yours and he joins the online live class, we will give you 500 as a referral amount bonus. So any question that you have regarding TCS or TCS Ninja or the online live classes or paid material, make sure that you ask that particular question in the comment section below, and we'll help you with all the questions and answers. And because in that way we understand what problems that the student is facing, and we reply to each and every comment. As you see with a lot of other videos, all replies, all questions get replies, whether on website, whether on YouTube. So ask questions, we will answer. Make sure that you do subscribe to our YouTube channel, because a lot of good videos are coming for TCS Ninja and all the other companies, and you don't want to miss them. Like this video and share it with your friends. And I will also suggest that if you are starting your preparation, make your own playlist for TCS or TCS Ninja as a personal reference, and add this video on YouTube in your playlist. So thank you for watching. If you have any question, we are always there to help. Best of luck. We are hoping that you join one of our courses, and just call on the numbers that are mentioned on the the website here. I'm showing that number again to you, and we'll help you as much as we can over the call or the WhatsApp. Take care.